Hi, and welcome to Lisa's Stamp Studio. My name is Lisa Curcio. Today, I'm going to teach you a budget-friendly project that is not only great for a stocking stuffer, but great for favors. Whether it's a holiday party, a classroom party, a birthday party, or even showers or wedding favors, this adorable project uses half of a pillow box, and it looks like this. Keep in mind, mine is Christmas-themed, but I also have an alternate sample to share with you as well, so make sure you hang with me to the end of the video. And don't forget to come back because I have another idea using this exact same pillow box that's totally different that you don't want to miss. If this is your first time visiting my YouTube channel, I would love to have you subscribe. Make sure you click on that subscribe button down below and hit that bell icon that's next to it. That bell icon will send you notifications when I'm live here on YouTube, as well as when I upload a new video. That will ensure you won't miss what I'm going to be sharing with these pillow boxes next. Let's head over to the stamp table and let's get started on today's project. We're going to start with one of the craft pillow boxes. There's 10 in a package, so they're really economical. The very first thing we're going to do is cut it in half at 3 inches. You can use your scissors or your paper trimmer for this. I'm going to set one of these aside, which is one reason why this is so budget friendly, because you're going to get two from one box. They are already scored for you on the bottom, so all you're going to have to do is just kind of feel for that score line on the inside of the box and just go ahead and press that down. You can go ahead and seal this with a couple glue dots if you'd like, but to be quite honest with you, the box is relatively small, so there really is not a lot of weight to it, so it does close very securely. To make this quick and easy, I decided to use Designer Series paper. This paper is from the Night Before Christmas series, and I couldn't resist that cute little cocoa pattern with the cookies here. I've got my 1.5-inch circle punch here, and I'm going to center it around one of the cocoa cups and the cookies. Because the image is slightly off-centered, I'm going to make sure that any excess is going to fall pretty much on this side where I'm going to put my greeting, and then we'll go ahead and punch that out. I went and used the Layering Circles dies to create a layer for that Designer Series paper. I've got my silicone craft sheet here. That's going to help keep my work surface nice and clean since adhesive liquid glue and hot glue will not stick to it. We'll just add some adhesive to that, and then we'll mirror this, leaving a border of that poppy parade color all the way around. The next thing I'm going to do is create a little bit of a curvature to this that'll fit very nicely on the curvature to the front of that box. So I'm taking my bone folder, and very much like you would curling ribbon, I'm starting in the center and I'm going to curl my way out. You don't have to create a lot of curvature, just enough to kind of bow the cardstock and just break up some of the fibers. That will ensure that we'll rest nicely. My next step is on a piece of very vanilla scrap cardstock, and I'm going to be using the Early Espresso ink pad. One of the things I absolutely love about Stampin' Up! Is the color coordination. So the colors in the Designer Series papers are reminiscent with our ink pads, markers, etc. I pulled out the greeting that says, "Oh, what yum," and this is from one of my very favorite holiday stamp sets called Itty Bitty Christmas. You're going to see how abundant it is here with greetings for both the outside and inside of your cards, as well as for favors. That product is featured in the current Stampin' Up! Holiday Catalog. Now, if you don't already have a demonstrator and you're interested in receiving complimentary copies of both the annual and the holiday catalog, head over to lisasstampstudio.com and click on Contact Me. I'm going to ink that up and we'll stamp that here on our scrap. To keep this quick and easy, I'm going to bring in my 1-inch circle punch and I'm going to line that up around my greeting and just punch that out. I want to create a little curvature to this too, so that it'll mimic the image that we're going to put it on. And I'm going to add adhesive only on the back right side because it's going to go here. So again, using my silicone craft sheet, I don't have to worry about any of that overage of that adhesive falling on my work surface. And that will allow me to align it here on the left-hand side. I wanted to add a little bit more color to this pillow box half that we've created here. So I've cut off 14 inches of the beautiful coordinating poppy ribbon. I'm going to start here on the right hand side and I'm going to loop it. And then I'm going to come back over to the left. Any excess we can trim away. Now I've tried all kinds of things to adhere this and this is rather large. So I decided that a piece of household tape worked wonders. I've got a piece of that tape here and I'm going to tack that down right here in the center of my box. I'll take my scissors and give that other end a trim. And now we're going to flip this over and we're going to add dimensionals to the back side. Now you're going to want to make sure you place your dimensionals only at the top and the bottom. I'm going to use my take your pick pickup tool with the paper piercing tool attachment. That's going to help me lift off those paper backings. And this now is going to get mirrored right over that scotch tape and tacked in place. The 3-inch by 6-inch gusseted cellophane bags are absolutely wonderful. So I took one of those out here and I filled them with a few few mini bite-sized cookies. Now, of course, for those of you that love to bake, this is a great way for you to give fresh homemade goodies with your little favor. I tucked those inside. I used a simple strand of burlap ribbon to tie it up, and then I did trim the bag down so that it was more conducive to the size of this little box. As I promised in the introduction, I have one more sample for you that is not Christmas. This one actually is holding chocolates, the exact same bag, the exact same way that I tied it up. All I did was change up the stamp set and the ribbon on this one as well. This one uses the piece of cake stamp set along with the cake builder punch, which makes it really easy. And I used my alcohol-based Stampin' Blends markers to add a little color here to my cake. Whether you're making these for a stocking stuffer or for friends and coworkers for the holidays or for parties, I think you're going to find this idea really budget-friendly and easy to achieve in just moments. If you have enjoyed today's video, please give it a thumbs up here on YouTube, which is a like, and I'm so glad that you joined me, and I look forward to having you with me next time. Have a great day.